Hi, this is Rohit Singh from TCA Training and Development, and I am working here as a data science and data analytics trainer for the last 6 years. In data science, my core expertise are in machine learning, deep learning, and NLP. In machine learning, I generally cover three topics, that is supervised learning, unsupervised learning, as well as reinforcement learning. In deep learning part, mostly I cover on neural networking, and we talk there two types of libraries, or we can say that framework. In deep learning, we cover two frameworks. One is TensorFlow and another one is Keras. And we cover almost 9 to 10 projects in our data science classes. And those projects are basically minor level as well as major level projects. Some of the projects are sentiment analysis, car rental system, opinion poll, face detection, as well as COVID dataset analysis. Data analytics is basically done through two languages. One is Python, other one is R. See, R is basically developed for analytics as well as data. But Python has dominated R, reason being its libraries and wide use. Like Python is being used in IoT as well as web development, data analytics, data science, for machine learning, AI, and all other part. So mostly the people learn Python due to its large amount of libraries, already I have said. The part that I mostly cover is basically Python libraries, Python, core Python, as well as Power BI in data analytics. Data analytics basically works on ETL as its first part. ETL is basically extraction, transformation, and loading. After that, we do the visualization part. And after visualization part, we do some insight gaining. And after insight gaining, we do some data analytics is basically covering three sections. That is ETL, extraction, transformation, and loading of data. Extraction means you have to gather the data first. Transformation means whatever the necessary changes you want to make, that you done through transformation. And loading means you have to load the data, whatever the tools you are using or whatever the programming languages you are using. After that, the visualization part is done. When you do the visualization, you get the insights from that particular visualization. And from that insights, you can do forecasting. Forecasting is basically getting the expected value for the last 5 years, 10 years, whatever the data may be. The life cycle of data science basically covers, first is business understanding, second one is data gathering, third is data mining, fourth one is data engineering, fifth is exploration of data, that is called EDA, exploratory data analysis, sixth is basically predictions of the model, and last one is deployment of the model in real world. If anyone want to join our data science or data analytics classes, you can contact us through our website, that is tcaindia.in. Thank you.
Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more informative videos, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.